Transformers Dark of the Moon is the third installment in the Transformers franchise, and I thought that it was a movie. It was a movie. I saw Transformers a while ago on opening day, and basically when I went in to go see it, all I was expecting were robot battles. What did I get? Robot battles! That's all that was in this movie, robot battles. And I was kind of expecting it to be pretty bad too, with Revenge of the Fallen being god-awful. And I haven't even seen the first one, so that kind of proves it. My friend I saw it with, he saw the first one, missed the second one. I missed the first one and saw the second one. So we, like, put it together and it turned out perfectly. I'm just going to go over the things that just bugged me and the things I liked. First of all, let's get this out of the way. The effects were amazing. The end, see it in 3D. IMAX 3D. It's worth the extra money. It's like wasting your money if you don't see it in 3D. So, anyway, getting that out of the way. The plot was shit. It's actually, it actually felt like two different movies that split up around the halfway point. So, the first half was like a subtle Revenge of the Fallen type, you know, no action, just like this subtle adventure. And then the second half felt like Battle Los Angeles. So, if you love Battle Los Angeles, you will by far love this movie. Just saying. The humor was pretty bad. Very bad. Actually, they would have something like really serious and cool going, and then they just bam cut away to something stupid. Like the like in the beginning, they have this cool opening sequence, and then it cuts away and it's their ass. So it's like whatever. The acting, I thought Shia LaBeouf, he was good, or he was the same. He was the same. John Turturro was the same. He was the same. The parents were the same, except John Turturro and the parents, they had little doses, so it was bearable. And the new chick who was playing, she was replacing Megan Fox, I think she did really good for her part. She was, she's not an actress, this is her first movie. She's a model. For not being an actress, I think she did pretty good. Just want to say that. And now, I don't know. I'm trying to think. The acting in general was pretty good. I think that I actually like the minor characters more than the major characters. Like, John Malkovich, I loved him. He was hilarious, you know? Like, I keep thinking back to when they were on, like, when he was interviewing Shia LaBeouf. And then, Ken Jeong, I knew he was in there, but my friend didn't, so he freaked out when he saw him. And he was unbelievably hilarious the whole time, you know? And it's like, just crazy, since I love The Hangover so much, if you've seen my review. And I don't know. I really don't know. The acting was okay, effects were great. Basically, this movie is robot battles. If you want to see robot battles, you will love this movie. If you don't, then you will hate this movie. Simple as that, okay? I want to say one spoiler-ish related thing, so if you don't want the movie ruined for you, which I don't know why, don't watch this. But it doesn't really matter, so whatever. The only thing I want to say is that the franchise, not really franchise, I would say, I don't know if this is going to be the last one. They said that Spielberg will direct the next one if there is a next one, but it's basically, I loved how this one ended on Optimus Prime versus Megatron. That was classic. And that's it. That's all I wanted to say. Rating, I'll give this movie a rating of, I'll give it a 40%. Oh, and it was way too long. Forgot to say that. Way too long. And 2.5 hours is way too long. So, I think 2 hours was good. I'll give it a 40%. 50%. That's good for me. 50%. And tell me in the comments what you thought about it. Subscribe for some more news and reviews and entertainment. Leave me a rating if you want to. And for right now, that's all you need to know about Transformers: Dark of the Moon.